Good evening, everyone. I welcome you to this video as well as the new subscribers. Feast of Trumpets, our last 40 days before the rapture, tribulation, 20 September 2020. No, it's not a date setting. Every year, Feast of Trumpets is a dress rehearsal for the coming of Jesus. We're entering the last 7 years. This coming September, 20 September 2020, according to Daniel 9:24-27, we are in the last 7 years, and it will begin on 20 September. And without a doubt, I believe Jesus will come for us in the clouds, and the rapture, the tribulation will begin. Yes, the normal time, Jesus began his ministry 27 AD. He was baptized in August by John around about 20th of August, and straight away Jesus went into the desert and he started fasting for 40 days. And Jesus began his ministry on Feast of Trumpets, and he will return also the same time during 7 years later. Feast of Trumpets, the last 40 days. We started our time frame. Actually, we started tonight, and God doesn't work according to the Gregorian calendar, but according to his time frame. It is from 6 p.m. to 6 p.m. the next day. Now, ours is from 12 a.m. to the next 12 a.m. Doesn't work in God's calendar like that. Okay, so what is Feast of Trumpets about? Many ask me, and just give you a preview what Feast of Trumpets is really about. Feast of Trumpets is also called the head the head year. That is what Feast of Trumpets is known for. Now, as I say, many Christians will say we are false prophets. They say this because of their understanding of what Yeshua said in Matthew 24:36, but concerning that day and hour, no one knows, not even the angels of heaven, nor the Son, but the Father only. If you do not know that Feast of Trumpets is the day that no man knows the day or an hour, that is the feast, and that is what Jesus was referring to Feast of Trumpets. Yes. It's also concerning the ancient Jewish wedding, where the father arranged the bride for the groom, and he prepares a place in his house, and the father does the same thing. Father prepares a place for us in heaven. Yes, if you do not know that, and here on earth in the ancient Jewish days, the father prepared the wedding, and he let his son know, now you are ready to go and fetch your bride. I believe the wedding is set already. Feast of Trumpets is known for the rapture and the beginning of the tribulation. Watch the video, don't switch it off. We'll come to that now. Now, it's also because those people that call us false prophets, they do not keep the appointed times that Yeshua was expressing in Leviticus 23. One of the feast days of Leviticus 23 is known as the feast that comes at a day and an hour no one knows. It is on this day that Yeshua was born, that Adam was born, and Sirius, yeah. And Jesus was born on 3 BC, 9/11. We all know about the famous towers that went down on 9/11. And it is on this very same time that Jesus will come again in the future, and this future is now this coming September, and we can see the signs. It's all over there. It's you cannot miss it, people. You cannot miss it. Now the false teachers will not be keeping these holy days, and they will call on those who do so, false prophets and heretics, as Isaiah said, calling evil good and good evil. Yeah, this is not a date, as I said. It's a dress rehearsal. Every year, Feast of Trumpets is a dress rehearsal for the coming of Jesus. Don't switch off the video. It's more. The biblical commands concerning the Feast of Trumpets, Leviticus 23 to 25, the Lord said to Moses, say unto the Israelites, it's not just for the Israelites. We've been taught it is a Jewish feast. It is God's feast, people. It is God's feast. And he require all believers in Christ to follow the feast. Of course, not the animal sacrifices, because Jesus became that sacrifice. On the first day of the seventh month, you are to have a day of rest, a sacred assembly commemorated with a trumpet blast. Do not do no regular work, but present an offering unto the Lord. And you can further read there about the offering in Exodus 23, verse 14, where God said, three times a year you shall go up unto Jerusalem, and that is for the feast. That, of course, is Passover, Pentecost, and Tabernacles. And the Bible says you shall not come empty-handed before the Lord. Yeah, so that is about the offering. We do not do animal sacrifices. Jesus became our perfect lamb. The biblical commands concerning the Feast of Trumpets, that is Numbers 10, 1 to 10. The Lord said to Moses, make two trumpets of hammer, silver, and use them for calling the community together and for having the camp set out. That is what those trumpets are known for. There are different reasons why God used trumpets. And the seven trumpet judgment got nothing to do with the last trump. Coming to that in a moment. So hold on. So the four main reasons for blowing the trumpets in this passage are assembling the whole congregation together, setting out to a new destination. And you can read when Israel traveled in the desert about the blowing of the trumpet. You can read about it. And the times of rejoicing at the appointed feast and festivals, and also when battle and war was about to begin. The devil is very fearful about that trumpet sound. Okay? So, yeah, and as mentioned earlier, as I said, the Feast of Trumpets starts on the Jewish month, which is Tishri the first. Yeah, but that, of course, is in our calendar, September the 20th. Now, that is why I said September the 20th, and then you see that date. Another date setter. No, it's not a date setter. Hey, corner. It is a two-day feast, Tishri, day one and day two, because feast requires a sighting of the new moon, and then the sighting had to be reported to the Sanhedrin and to the priest. Because of the uncertainty when exactly this will occur, it is celebrated over 2 days, Tishri 1 to a Day of Atonement on Tishri. 10 days are collectively called the Days of Awe. So I'll explain to you in a moment what is the Days of Awe. In fact, preparing for this time if even starts in the previous month, and that is called, where we are right now, the month of August. The previous month of Elul, as they call it, August starts 40-day period known as Tesavu, meaning to repent or return, which concludes on the Day of Atonement in the following month of Tishri, September, as we know it in our months. Yeah. So the preparation, Jesus also started his preparation, as I said, in the beginning, right from the time when he was baptized by John, 27 AD, on the 80th Jubilee. That's when Jesus prepared, and he also had a time of praying and preparing for this holy feast. And every year, the high priest goes into that's on Day of Atonement once a year to apply the blood upon the horns of the altar that is in the Holy of Holies, and that high priest has to be so prepared. He had to have no sin. He had to repent. He had to be clean, because he goes into the Holy of Holies in the direct presence of God. And they tied bells to him, you know, and a rope in case he die inside that, in the Holy of Holies. And that already happened in the past. Some priests that died. Yeah. And then they pull him out, and as long as they hear the bells inside, they know everything is fine. Yeah. And once a year, the priest apply the blood upon the horns of the altar, and then all Israel's sins were forgiven for that year. But we all know, of course, that Jesus came for us on the feast of Passover and became that sacrificial lamb. So I hope you understand that now. But Jesus will return 7 years later from this coming September. That will be in 2027. And Jesus will atone for Israel that warred with the Antichrist. So Jesus will then return then 2027 on Feast of Atonement. But also then Jesus will return earlier. Jesus will return earlier to do the same thing again, what we are doing right now, those 40 days preparation before the feast, the fall feast begin. So Jesus will return 40 days earlier. And that, of course, is with the greatest earthquake in Revelation 16, verse 18. That is the time that Jesus will return. Also in August, he will return. And, of course, everything will be destroyed at that time. It will be the greatest earthquake in the history of all histories, if I had to put it like that. Never ever will there be such a great earthquake. Every building in every city will be flattened on that day. The only place that will be raised will be Mount Zion, will be raised in Jerusalem. And in fact, Mount Olives split in two on that day when Jesus returned. And then the preparation began for the feast, the fall feast. Yes, the feast will be in operation in, yes, it will be in operation during the millennium. So those that told you we should not celebrate the feast or observe the feast is lying to you people. Yes, for each day during Elul, the trumpet ram horn is blown to remind the people to this during the 40 days to return to God in preparation for the upcoming days of awe between Tishri 1 and 10. everyone had to search their own heart during this period and make sure they were right with God. So this is what you need to do. You can get your own trumpet on a CD or whatever you play it and blow that trumpet. Yeah, and that trumpet is a reminding yourself of to repent. And I tell you, the devil is very scared of that trumpet sound. So you blow your own trumpet, or if you do have a trumpet like that, you can blow it as well. Yeah, so that is what Feast of Trumpets is about. Feast of Trumpets finds its fulfillment in the rapture of the church, not the full church. That is the wrong termination. Many people say it's a church, but it is the first fruit of the church. It's not a church that will be raptured. Only those that are spotless people. Jesus comes for a spotless bride. And if you do not believe in his feast, he's not coming for you. That is a fact. Jesus is not coming for you. And if you're not looking for Christ, Christ will not come for you. The entire Days of Oz period mentioned about above finds its fulfillment in a coming 7-year period, often stated as Jacob's trouble. And I'll show you that picture now in a moment, and I will also conclude my message there, which leads to the return of Christ at his second coming in all glory. As I say, it's a 7-year period from 20 September right unto September, Feast of Trumpets. September can be October as well for that number matter, because it always happened either September or October. So in 7-year period from that time, Jesus will return, and that will be 2027. And then, of course, I said Jesus will prepare for that time as well. Yeah, so it is 7 years, people, not 3.5 years, like many people tell you. The Bible clearly states 70 weeks are determined upon my people. 69 of that is fulfilled when Jesus died on the cross. So there is 7 years left. There are 7 years left, which commences this 20 September 2020. Now, this is a piece, that I actually wanted to mention there. Yeah, now, this is just the graph here about the Days of Awe. Tishri, or September 19th and 20th, over 2 days. I suspect the Lord will come on the second day, on the 20th of September. And the secret day where God gives us a clue is the moon under the feet of the woman. The moon under the feet of the woman, you know. That is where. And that moon arrives exactly at 12 noon there. At 12 noon. And what did Jesus say about that day? In Amos 8 verse 9, he said, "I will darken the day. I will darken the day at noon." That is what the Lord says. I'll turn the day in darkness at noon. Now, Feast of Trumpets, yeah, it's a second day feast, as known as a Day of Awakening. What do you mean by Day of Awakening? The Jews believe that the dead in Christ will rise on the Feast of Trumpets, and we may also, the Jews also believe that their Messiah, they rejected Jesus, of course, and that their Messiah will be killed in battle. And yeah, the Jews believe that Donald Trump is their Messiah, and yeah, Donald Trump actually mentioned about something about his assassination, that people want to kill him. So we will expect him that he will die in September, and that he will be raised. And that is also the day that he may be raised on 20th of September. Yeah, and began his work then on the 21st of September. Feast of Trumpets is also known as the Day of Judgment. Yes, the Day of Judgment. And that is what is coming. The sixth seal will be coming on this day. That is what will happen. That is what Feast of Trumpets is known for. It is a day of remembrance when God opens the book, the books. You remember with Haman and the king, he opened a book and they remember such a day, and Haman came to remembrance on that day. Yeah. You remember Haman was blessed and he had to ride on a colt. Now, coronations of the kings takes place on the Feast of Trumpets. Yeah, Jesus, when he will be crowned king, you know, is the opening of the gates. What do you mean, opening of the gates? There's an open gate in Book of Revelation. There's a Book of Revelation. Opening of the gates takes place around about September. Yes, and there is a gate, open door. Revelation 4 verse 1, come up here, come up here. Yeah, that's when the gates will open. And then the last trump is blown on Feast of Trumpets. Now the last trump is not the seven trumpet judgment of the book of Revelation. In Feast of Trumpets, people, Feast of Trumpets, there were 100 trumpets being blown on that day. And the 100 trump, the 100 trump, the last trump, which is the last trump of the day, is the long tequila. That is the last trump. That is the last trump that Paul is referring to, and he tells you actually at the last trump. In other words, what Paul was saying, the rapture will happen at Feast of Trumpets. You got it? Yeah. So the last trump fulfilled at the rapture and the resurrection. When the trump blows, I'm telling you, those dead in Christ will rise first, and which we will alive in a twinkling of an eye will be resurrected, and we will be with Jesus forever. Not on Day of Atonement, like that other lady said, Brenda said, it's not the case. It is on Feast of Trumpets. Now, the days of all this 7 days between Tishri 10 and Tishri 3rd, these are those 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These 7 days period, the feast corresponding to a future 7-year tribulation period known as Daniel, the 70th week, the time of Jacob's trouble, the day of the Lord, the birth pangs of the Messiah, and the day of wrath. The day of wrath begins with Revelation 6:17, people. Yeah, these consist of the six seal judgment, the trumpet, and the bowl judgment of Revelation. Yeah, that's where it actually began. And the four horsemen, the four horsemen is pre-tribulation. The Antichrist has already been, and the false prophet has already been revealed, people. They start there. Their assignment just after the rapture, that is when they will get full power to reign. But they already know who they are. Yes. As I said, that the Day of Atonement is Israel's holiest day, known as the day face to face. Close what Jesus said to Pastor Dana. He said, arise, my bride. Arise, rise and pray. Arise and battle. And arise to see me face to face. Wow, that is powerful. And we will see Jesus face to face. And the Father. Father is coming with there is silence in heaven for half an hour. And that is time that Jesus is coming to fetch his bride with everybody coming with. And that's why there's silence in heaven for that time, for half an hour. And then we were back praising the Lord again. Yeah. So that is the great, the closing of the gates, the great trump, the fulfillment and the second coming of Jesus. I will put the rest of those notes for you. I don't want to include it all. It will be too many for you. So that will end my presentation here. So be blessed, people. Please share this video. It's very important that you share it. That is what Feast of Trumpets is known for. We are in the last 7 years. And I said it already for the last 2 years. I've been teaching that. But people do not pay attention. God bless you. I love you all. Thanks for your giving and thanks for the prayer. Bless you. Bye.